Hi everyone, this is Gail Dudley with your News in Motion. How are you today? Talk to me, talk to me. Who's out here this morning? Talk to me this morning. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Miriam. Good morning, Jacqueline. Hey, with you two being on here first, pray for me. I'm not feeling good this morning, y'all. I'm fighting something. Good morning, Kenya. I'm fighting something. I woke up this morning like, I do not feel the best, so I need y'all prayer warriors out there praying for me, please, please. Good morning, Jeffrey. Good morning, Diane. Good morning, Deborah Sneed. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. If you're just joining me, good morning, Karen. I asked Marion and Jacqueline, they're the first two people I saw come up. Good morning, Paige. I was like, pray for me. I am not feeling my best this morning. Good morning, Kelly Meekley. Good morning, Tamia. Good morning. So I'm gonna let y'all in on a little bit of insight. First of all, today is Tuesday, January the 5th, 2020. Good morning, Deborah. Again, if y'all just coming in, pray for me. I am not feeling the best this morning, but I'm gonna share this with y'all. At 1 o'clock, good morning, Lori. Good morning, Kenny. Good morning, Ann Annette. Around 1 o'clock this morning, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, Demia. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Y'all, this morning around 1 o'clock, if y'all remember, was it last week or the week before, where we went into a serious praise break. Good morning, John Gore. Good morning, Carolyn. Good. Carolyn, how's your knee? How's your knee? When we went into that praise time and we kind of like flipped the script, or God flipped the script, it ended up being good news in motion. We had an image of all of y'all's prayers and praise. Good morning, Oscar. So at 1 o'clock this morning, I literally went through every last single one of them again. I was led to grab my phone and I started praying for you all individually. I don't know if Bill Palmer's on here or not. Good morning, Felicia. But Bill, I want to ask about your shoulder too. I was praying breakthroughs for those of you who are asking breakthroughs for a breakthrough. John, I was praying for Janae. I was just praying for every post that was on there. And I ended up bawling. Good morning, Pam Carr. Y'all can tell now I'm just a crybaby. I ended up bawling, praying for y'all at 1 o'clock. Then when I woke up around 4:30, God gave me a word to give to my husband. Good morning, Pastor Alex. Good morning, Adrian. And I gave him the word. And he just looked at me. And I can just tell. And I said, you don't have to say anything in return. And when he just looked at me, I knew that that was a word that he was seeking for and that he needed confirmation for. Good morning, Patricia. Good morning, Mary. So ever since, I prayed for those of you who had prayer requests on the thing from that Good News in Motion segment, and giving that word to my husband, being obedient, I have felt ill. I'm like, I know this is nobody but the enemy. I know it's nobody but the enemy, but we shall prevail. We shall prevail. Because I was like, I can't get on here this morning. Good morning, Anita. Good morning. Who else was that? I didn't see that. Sorry about that. I wasn't going to get on this morning because I was feeling bad. I was feeling ill. And I said, nope, 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 nope. The prayer warriors are on here. They're going to get me through because we have news to deliver today. But even regardless of the news, God was just showing me that we're going to pray this month and we're going to use this community to pray accordingly. So let me get started. So if I'm not my high self today, y'all know why. I'm having my own little battle. So y'all, today is January the 5th, and you know what today is. This is the runoff election in Georgia. And we need to pray for people in Georgia. We need to pray for those who are at the voting booths, who are working it, who are doing their civic duty. We need to pray. Now, the word is that people who have requested a mail-in ballot, there's many people that have not received them. If that's the case, you can still go to iwillvote.com, Georgia. Go to iwillvote.com and look for your precinct. Go to your precinct and tell them to cancel your mail-in ballot request, and they'll see that you haven't turned it in, and then vote there on site. So if you know anybody in Georgia, please give them this word. Please let them know. I received an alert that said, request a mail-in ballot, but haven't received it. You can vote in person tomorrow. Tell the person at the check-in table that you wish to cancel your request, your requested mail-in ballot, and vote in person instead. So you do have that right. And if you have any questions, y'all go to iwillvote.com. There are people standing by who could walk you through. Governor Andrew Cuomo, confirms the first case of the UK COVID strain in New York. And they're saying that this new strain, this new variant, is moving rapidly. Y'all, disparities, minority-owned companies waited months for PPP loans and they didn't get them. 93% of minority small business owners did not receive PPP. There were more white business owners for the small business loan program than anyone else. And that's AP reporting. So we still have disparities there. Here's a quote from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. She says, justice is about the water we drink. Justice is about the air we breathe. Justice is about how easy it is to vote. Justice is about how much ladies get paid. Justice is about making sure that being polite is not the same thing as being quiet. In fact, oftentimes the most righteous thing you can do is to shake the table. And that's our quote for today. And there's some tables that need to be shaken. Minimum wage, y'all, 20 states and 32 smaller localities raised their minimum wage, 27 of those to $15 per hour or more. And that went into effect January the 1st. Me too, Pam, I love that quote. Y'all, Proud Boys is preparing to rally in DC on tomorrow. Their leader was arrested the moment he got off the plane in DC. The leader was arrested because they found footage that said that he was the one who took the Black Lives Matter banner from the historical Black church during the demonstration last month. So he was arrested. Coronavirus numbers in the U.S. confirmed cases 21,353,051. That's 21,353,051 deaths. Again, I go to the World Health Organization, 362,123, and recovered 12,736,512. Recovered 12,736,512. Y'all, vaccines are not going as planned. Good morning, Sylvia Jones. Vaccines are not going according to plan. The U.S. has fallen far short of the goal to administer 20 million doses. That was by the end of last year. That was 2020. Only 2.8 million. So out of 20 million, only 2.8 million. Y'all, here's something. Dr. Fauci says, you know, he's going to be moving on with the Biden administration. So from the Trump administration to the Biden administration. Dr. Fauci says COVID-19 vaccines could be mandatory for travel, including hotel stays. So something to think about, people. Something to think about. Y'all, California funeral homes are running out of space as communities across the country feel the pain of the surge of the coronavirus cases. Funeral homes in the hot spots of Southern California say they must turn away grieving families as they run out of space as bodies are piling up. So that is happening. That is happening. Yeah, that's right, Mike Nicholson, COVID passports. And we're still praying for you, Mike. We're still praying for you and with your family. All right, I wanted to do something a little different today. And again, this is the new year. We're doing something different. And I can't give y'all my punch like I want to because I feel like my body is just like shrinking down as I'm here. But we're going to get through this. And I just know that y'all still praying for me. Again, I pray for each one of y'all by name who put in a prayer request. During that time, we had Good News in Motion. And then I gave a word to my husband about 4:30 this morning. And it was like the enemy said, really? And just like sucker punched me. And my body is like, what is happening? I just feel like I'm going down, but the devil is a lie. I'm not going down. So I want to talk about empowerment. So if you have pen and paper, pull it out, because I'm going to give you some nuggets. And this is something we're going to do each week as well. Not every day, but each week. Empowerment. Number one, we have to have a social responsibility. We have to have a social responsibility. And that means knowing your community, beginning with your immediate neighborhood. And this is a little bit of what I shared back in, I believe, October. But your social responsibility, know your community. Know your community. Michael, you're absolutely, you are welcome. You are family. You are family. We just want to love on you, check on you, pray for you and your family in the passing of your sister. So, and if your mom's on here, we want to be praying for her as well. So y'all, social responsibility. So question would be, in this year, what's our social responsibility individually within our communities? What does that look like? So that when we hear of the Proud Boys coming into town, for us not to react, but for us to strategize, what's our social responsibility? As children are going back to school in some places, what's our social responsibility to, even if we don't have any children in the school system, but we live in that neighborhood, what is our social responsibility? How do we get involved and what does that look like, y'all? This is all about the news. So even when we hear someone asking to just simply find 11,780 votes, what's just one more than what they need or what they have? What's our social responsibility? You know, what's our social responsibility? How do we respond to that? How do we write legislation? What does that look like for our community? How do we teach, even if we don't have children, how do we teach children in the community that that's no way to act? What is our social responsibility? Then number two, political knowledge. That's empowered to get involved on a local level. Again, what are the issues locally? You know, you're probably saying we're so done with politics, but let me tell you right now, everything is political. Everything is political. That small business in your neighborhood, that's political. That recreation center, that's political. Everything you do, that's political. That bank that you're banking at, that's political. The fees that they keep taking out of your bank and changing things, that's political. The fact that African Americans or minority business cannot get PPP loans, that's political. So y'all, you have now your social responsibility and also the political knowledge. How can you get involved? How do you spend your dollars there? How are you making sure that you are putting your money back into your community? Y'all, this is our empowerment. These are things that we need to do. This is something that's ongoing. We just can't say the election is over so I can rest. No, now is when the real fight begins, because we have to keep holding these people accountable. The next one, number three, is generating income, building wealth, y'all. Building wealth, y'all. We have to learn how to build wealth. We have to learn how to do that. Do we put together a farmer's market? Our social responsibility in our local community, which is a political knowledge. Well, how do we do that? Do we put a farmer's market in our local community? Do we have watchmen on the towers walking around the neighborhood? Do we make sure we put good produce in our local communities, y'all? In the poor communities, the produce look like mess. It looks like mess. So what do we do as a community to have a farmer's market, to grow our own food, our own spices, our own herbs? What are we doing? What is our responsibility socially, but also building wealth, building community income, building that income that's going to make a difference? Do we put schools in different areas? And I'm talking daycares or whatnot in the local community to see that difference come forward. So that, again, when we have another election, that we have a place that we're also a training ground for other people to do what needs to be done, so that they're putting together their civic engagement and their civic duty, and they have an understanding. How often do we build wealth and talk about, you know, we laugh at the lemonade stands, but the lemonade stands made a lot of money when we were younger. So how do we reproduce that now that we are older? How do we build that wealth? And not only build that wealth, but keep that wealth in our local communities, y'all. What does that look like? So generating income, then education. Every day should be a learning opportunity. Every day, so that's number four, education. Every day should be a learning opportunity. And what does that look like for you? What are you learning? Are you learning about your health? Are you learning about your well-being? And again, we see Mike on here, and Mike is, he's doing hip-hop fitness, but he's also educating people. So that education needs to be there. I see Ashley just jumped on here. Ashley talks about women empowerment. So we need to understand that empowerment of women. I see John Gore on here. He's talking about mentorship. So y'all, this educational piece, every day learning opportunity, everyday learning opportunity. I see Gina on here. Gina is a serious Mike. You need to check with Gina on your podcast. Mike, check with Gina. Gina's on here with her podcast. You need to check that out. Gina can educate people on podcasts. And what does that look like? See, one thing we need to do, we need to become more resourceful and touch those resources that we need to do those things that we need to do. I see Mary Jenkins on here. I don't know who's praying for me, y'all, but thank you. But I feel like my sickness is moving on out of here. Praise Jesus, because I'm telling y'all, I felt like, and you know, today in the era of COVID, I was like, what is happening? So y'all keep praying. I feel my help. I knew. See, the enemy was trying to tell me not to come on here today because I was sick. No. I said, no, the people need to pray for me or on here. So I'm glad I did it because I feel a transformation. I feel a shifting in the atmosphere. So thank y'all. Y'all just keep praying for me. But I see Mary Jenkins on here. Mary Jenkins can tell you all about cancer. She has a nonprofit organization called, the name has changed, but I know it from the way it was first born, Christians Overcoming Cancer. I think it's now it's just COC. I don't know. But anyway, Christians Overcoming Cancer. She has resources available. She knows how to deal with people. She knows how to connect with people. She knows how to partner with people. She knows how to raise some serious cash. So we need to really learn about the differences and the opportunities that we have, y'all. This is all about the news. It's one thing just to give you news, but now we need to know what to do with it now that we know about it. We need to be educated. This is what could have happened yesterday. Technically, Trump flying into Georgia, because it was a state issue that he was trying to incite election fraud, he should have been arrested when he got off that plane. There was every right. He should have been arrested. That's education. That's what people don't read. They're like, oh, you can't arrest him because he's a... Yeah, you can. That's a state issue. You see his behind ain't going to New York. Have you seen him in New York lately? He's not in New York. He refuses to go to the state of New York. He gets right there on the line going to New Jersey to one of his golf places. He owns a tower there. He ain't been to New York. He knows if he lands that plane in New York, Letitia James is coming for him. She got some cuffs with his name on it. See, this is the education we need to understand so we stop spewing things that are not true or we don't have all of our knowledge behind that. They could have arrested him yesterday. That would have been a beautiful sight, but they didn't. But that's education. We need to start educating people. Now, we need to educate each other about wealth building. What does that look like? How do we invest? The reasons we're not investing is because we don't even know how to do it. Many of us. We need to learn how to do that. We need to learn how to do that. When I was reading the book of the week is The Green Print. The book of the week is Green Print. When I was reading that book the other day, did y'all know y'all could get produce delivered to your house? Did you know that you can pay a fee and produce is delivered in a box to your house every week? Did y'all know that? I'll put the link on there later on. But I was reading this, so then of course I went to Google. Google is your friend. I'm Googling it, seeing what it looks like, seeing what it costs, seeing how it builds the community. I looked at that, and y'all, for those in Ohio, there's one in Mount Vernon, Ohio. And then they do offshoots all around different communities. See, we don't know about that. And I said, we can do that? And I'm talking some serious, fresh, mess on it. Now I don't know the name I'm looking for, but no mess on it. It's like organic. It is fresh. It is juicy. Yeah, I signed up and it's not expensive at all. It's not expensive. You can choose to have it delivered to your grocery store or delivered to your house. Say, what? Yeah, that's happening. And that is happening. That is helping the local farmers to continue to be farmers within your community. Y'all, that's building wealth. That's education. That's generating income. That's political knowledge. That's social responsibility. Because again, everything is political. Then y'all, we have volunteerism and philanthropy. And that's serving individually and collectively. So volunteerism and philanthropy. That's serving individually and collectively. Y'all, $1. $1 makes you a philanthropist. See, many of us believed a long time ago we weren't making millions or billions or didn't have thousands to give that we couldn't do that. No, a philanthropist starts at bare minimum, $1, $2, $5, whatever that looks like. Now, here's something with the Black community, because I know there's many people from different race, ethnic backgrounds, and so forth that watch this, but I want to talk to the Black community for a moment. Philanthropy is beyond your tithes and offering at your church. See, we want to stop there. Like, I done gave. That's all I'm going to give. And some of y'all don't do that either. But I done gave. That's all I'm going to give. Y'all just threw shade. And we think that's it. That's all I have to do. Okay, but what about the nonprofit organization? Because your church isn't giving to the nonprofit organization, except for those churches that have made a commitment to tie the 10 or 20 or 30% out to local communities. But see, we want to stop right there at church like we've done something. No, it's bigger than that. It's broader than that. And we need to start learning how to serve in those areas. See, that's how you get to the table. When you start sowing, like for example, not giving personal business per se, but for example, I give to the Women's Fund. I give to the Women's Fund every month. Every month. No matter how small it is, I give. What happens? They call me up. Hey, do you want to read some grants that just came in? We want you to help us identify which organization should get this money. Because I sold into the Women's Fund, and trust me, it is not a lot of money at whatsoever at all. I'm invited to come to the table to read the grants that people write in, and I am looking at the Black community. I was in a group last year. And, you know, we had the rules. We had the standards that we had to follow. And I'm sitting, you know, we're on Zoom. Everything's on Zoom. I'm sitting there, I'm like, no, we're not getting ready to sit them aside. Let's talk about the fact that maybe they didn't know how to write a proposal. Let's talk about the fact that maybe they didn't have the expertise to do what they need to do. But their mission is solid. So let's rethink about this. When I was done in that 5 to 10 minutes of arguing my case, they got every penny they asked for. See, but we get to the table because we are sowing, because we are connecting, because we are networking, y'all. That's what we need to do. So y'all, that's my section on empowerment today. I hope that was helpful. For the win, Boston Red Sox. The Boston Red Sox has announced that the team will hire Bianca Smith as a coach in its minor league development system, making her the first Black woman coach in the history of Major League Baseball. So not only does the Boston Red Sox get the win, but Bianca Smith also gets the win for doing her thing. Now, check this out, y'all. Bianca is a 29-year-old coach of a minor league players in Fort Myers, Florida, with a concentration on positioning players, a team official told the Boston Globe. So go ahead, Bianca Smith, go ahead. And shout out again to the Boston Red Sox. All right, y'all, the inspirational message, and I'm out of here. The spirit of offense stops the move of the Holy Spirit. I'll read that again. The spirit of offense stops the move of the Holy Spirit. I'll read that one more time. The spirit of offense stops the move of the Holy Spirit. Stop being offended. Stop being offended. Because the moment you are offended, you are stopping the move of the Holy Spirit. I'll say that again. Stop being offended. The moment that you become offended, it stops the move of the Holy Spirit. You know, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus comes to bring life and to bring it in abundance. See, if the enemy's coming to steal, kill, and destroy, we already know his moves. He comes to steal. He comes to steal our joy. He comes to steal our hope. He comes to steal our excitement. He comes to steal our time with God. He comes to kill. He comes to kill our motivation. He comes to kill those seeds that we have planted. He comes to shoot us down. He comes to kill us. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. He comes to destroy our dreams. The enemy comes to destroy what it is we want to do. The enemy comes to destroy our relationships. The enemy comes to destroy our businesses. The enemy comes to destroy our family. So we already know his game. His cards are already on the table. He comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. So why be offended about that? No longer should we be offended. No, because Jesus, the good news is Jesus comes to bring life and bring in abundance. So first of all, that comes on the back side of that scripture, John 10:10. So the front side, Jesus kind of tells you, this is what the enemy does. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But don't even worry about that. That's minor. That's peanuts to me because I come to bring life and bring in abundance. So why be offended? Offense will stop the move of the Holy Spirit. When you are in your flow, when you are moving as God has called you to move, there is no space for you to be offended. There's no space. If somebody comes and duplicates or copy what it is that you're doing, be like, okay, all right, now there's two of us. Let's do this together. Mess them up with that kind of response. When someone comes to poo-poo on what it is that you're doing in your community, go, okay, don't have a conversation with them. Just go, I see what's up. That's what's up. But you keep doing what you're doing and laugh as you walk away. Don't be offended. Don't waste your energy being offended over things that God has already said. Here's his cards. Here's what's on the table. But I come to bring life. I come to bring life in abundance. That means overflow. That means you have too much room to contain it. That means there's an overflow. There is joy. There is laughter. There is life. There is increase. There is healing. There is saving. There is knowledge. There is wisdom. All of that is coming forth to you today. So choose not to be offended because offense stops the move of the Holy Spirit. All right, y'all. I'm out of here. And I think we did it. I think we got back down to that 20 minutes, y'all. We did it. And y'all, by the way, I am feeling pretty good. It's like whatever that was had to go because y'all prayer warriors were praying. So since the move and the anointing is already on this community today, go ahead and drop your prayer requests in there. Even after I sign off, still go ahead and drop your request in there. Because, you know, when the anointing is flowing and when one person is getting blessed, when one person is being delivered, when one person is being healed, when one person's eyes are opening, when one person's ears are opening, when one person's heart starts beating, when one person is able to see supernaturally, that means that the blessings are in the house. So you might as well go ahead and get yours also. Don't let me get my praise on by myself. You might as well join me as you're getting healed, as you're being delivered, as you're being blessed, as you're becoming prosperous, as you're gaining wisdom, knowledge, and understanding as the Lord is blessing you on today. So go ahead and drop your prayer request in there even after I sign off. And just everyone, I ask that you come back and pray for the people and their requests that's there. I am Gail Dudley. Come on, Georgia. We got to do this. Remember, if you know anybody in Georgia, call them up and say, if you've been waiting on your ballot, it's too late to mail it today. If you've been waiting on your ballot, no problem. Go there. Go to iwillvote.com. See what your precinct is. Go in there. Cancel the mail-in ballot and go ahead and vote there. That is the legal thing to do. If they have any questions, I'm sure they can call Brad Ransberger because he's going to tell them, yep, give them a ballot because he about through with Buttercup. He's done with Buttercup. He's over with Buttercup. We just need to pray, y'all. All right, y'all. Thank y'all for praying for me today. Thank y'all for praying. Thank y'all for tuning in. Thank y'all for listening. Until tomorrow, I am Gail Dudley with your news in motion. You make it a great day. Mwah! Love you all. Peace out.